Hi, and welcome to the Comfy Red Couch. My name is Tracy, and I'm your host. And I am coming to you from a very cold February day in Toronto. The weather's kind of that nondescript sort of weather. You know, it was sunny earlier, it snowed overnight, it's gray now, but you can see that the sun might pop out a little bit later. Nondescript. So that is the weather report for Toronto for today. Today, I have lots of lovely things to share with you. I have not one, not two, but three finished objects to share with you this week, and I am so excited to get to that. But before I do, I'll let you know where you can find me. I am Tracy RR on Ravelry, and I am at Comfy Red Couch on Instagram. If you are new to the podcast, welcome. This is a podcast where I primarily talk about knitting, and today that's what it's going to be about. It's going to be two personal projects and a test knit that I'm going to share. So welcome, grab a seat, grab a nice drink, whether hot or cold, wherever you are, and sit down, relax, and I hope you'll enjoy what I'm going to share with you today. And if you are a returning viewer, welcome back. You know it. Always love having you here, and there is always plenty of space on the couch, and today no pets are up here for now. That changes probably throughout the podcast. Scout is on one of the red chairs and the other red chair is free, so grab a seat, grab your beverage of choice and your project bag, and let's get started with some tea time. And I did say, I think, that I have some brown paper packages today, this week. So one of my brown paper packages included this lovely mug. And I'm just showing you the back of the mug. But the front is absolutely darling. So it's like those lovely little stockinette stitches all around. And then these cute little buttons. So it's a nice warm sweater for my tea, which is going to go in here in a minute. And that is from Bluebird Pottery. And Bluebird Pottery is based in Toronto. And I don't know, I saw someone on Instagram showed a picture of one of the mugs with the buttons, and I thought, oh, that's really cute. And I was very enabled. I went to Etsy, and there wasn't much in stock, but there was this bluish green one, and I just thought it was just wonderful. I always love mugs, like clay pottery mugs. I just love them. This has a nice chunky handle too. So I have a new mug. So what am I drinking today? Well, same thing as I had last week. I am, but it's a lot lower than it was last week. Oh, I love the smell of this. This is my Rooibos Eucalyptus Zest from the Tea Palace. And as you can see, I am getting very, very low. That's okay. I've got some things to share with you. So I have made some tea in my little stump teapot, my Eucalyptus Zest. And last week I said that I was going to try and cut out the caffeine because I was just having so much difficulty sleeping and falling asleep. I'd go to bed at 11 o'clock and I'd still be wide awake at 1. And I was only really drinking the equivalent of one stump teapot of black tea, and then I was switching over to things like the eucalyptus zest or other caffeine-free free teas once I had finished my first cup. But I was often finishing my first cup about 4 or 5 o'clock p.m. of the caffeine. And I just was having such a difficult time sleeping. I thought I was going to get wicked headaches. I did not, thankfully. I had a couple little dull roars. But it was good. And for pretty much most of the week, I fell asleep fairly quickly. I still wake up in the night a couple of times, but it doesn't seem to be waking up and, you know, insomnia, just more wake up, either got to run to the bathroom or just wake up, roll over and switch positions, fall back asleep. So it's been better. I do miss my black tea, but thankfully I do have the eucalyptus zest. So I now have poured my eucalyptus zest in my new Bluebird Pottery tea mug. And, oh, this week. Let us cheer to getting that rest and relaxation that we all need. Cheers to that. Greg bought me a bunch of lemons to put in my tea this week, but today I'm just drinking it straight. It's still really, really good. Anyway, let's move on with my favorite things. And I have three finished objects to share with you, sort of. And that's because I've got some loose ends that I still need to weave in, or cut. But that's easily done. And I just thought, I'm just so excited to share these with you that you'll forgive the loose ends. And the first project I'm going to share with you hasn't been blocked either, because I finished it very, very late last night, about a little after midnight. I finished it about 12:30. And I just had to decide, do I want to wash my hair or do I want to finish this project? And I wanted to finish this project. So that's what I did. So for this project, I used this gorgeous skein, and there were two of them. This one just fell apart on me. And this is Turtle Pearl Yarns and Air Force One. And it is just such a lovely self-striping yarn. And I'm giving these as a gift, but I love them. I might have to make another pair. Maybe I might be able to fit some really, really shorty socks in here with lots of other highlights, but they're just so fun. And I used this red, which I think is also a Turtle Pearl Yarns, but I'm not 100% sure. And those were the colors I used. And that had been living in my lovely Little Bobbins Vintage Fairy Lights bag, which will now go away until next Christmas. And that's okay. It gets used at least once a year, sometimes more. But, maybe in summer, like in July, maybe I'll feel like pulling it out. But for now, it goes away. Anyway, this is one of the socks that I made. And this one is the other one. And as you can see, I still need to secure my ends. I did bring a couple blockers down to pop them on, and I'll just go through the sock with you. This is a vanilla pattern that I have come to like, that I've developed just from some of my favorite things. And this one has a 2x2 cuff, and I'll show that to you in a second once I've got these on the blockers. These are my large blockers, and that's good because these are large socks. So here we are. I just need one, I suppose. I have a 2x2 rib happening in the cuff, and I did 1.5 inches and then stockinette all the way down, and I wanted to split at the midway point of the blue because these reds don't quite match, so I wanted them far enough away that not like anyone's going to be looking at heels and toes, but sometimes cuffs pop up. I wanted the red here far enough away from the red here so that it was a nice highlight, but it wasn't obvious that they didn't match. So I was able to split perfectly on both of them right here for the heel, and I did a slip stitch heel flap, and then I did a square heel turn, and then I do have a lovely little gusset going down and the foot to where the blue ended and into the red toe, and I just did a regular wedge toe. And the wonderful thing about Turtle Pearl Yarns is you get your 100 grams, but they're split evenly into two small 50s, as I held up earlier, and they are perfectly matched socks. And these ones, I would say, are absolutely perfectly matched, and I am just so thrilled with how these have turned out. I do need to go in and secure all the ends where I switched yarn, so I'll have a couple ends on the toe, four ends in the heel area. And then, as you can see, I have three ends here, two at the join and one where I cast on. So not too much to do, just a few loose ends, and then these will be ready to soak, block, and then gift. We are not going back to work until next week, so next Tuesday we will be going back, and that's when I'll be able to gift these. So I'm glad that they're done, and I think they look fantastic. I would definitely get another self-striping of that Air Force One again, though I do have lots of turtle pearl yarns that need to be knit up first. Update to the weather report. It's now not looking like the sun is going to come out at all, but there are soft snowflakes falling down now. Gotta keep that update. Next project, let's stay on the lines of socks. And I am going to share my test knit for the first pattern from the Handmade Sock Society. And this pattern is called Curling Mist Socks. And for that, that was my Christmas Eve cast on that had been living in my lovely Yarn Magpie bag. I had to remember there for a second. And for this project, I used some lovely hedgerow yarns. And I used this sparkly, sparkly skein of cranberry. So this is cranberry on gold sparkle sock. And I hope it's catching those nice little sparkles right now. Lovely to work with again. And actually I'll leave that out because these bags are going to need to be taken upstairs. And again, that was hedgerow yarns and cranberry. So these socks are already on blockers, and two socks. This was such a lovely knit. I thought when I first saw them, oh, that's going to take a lot of attention, but it didn't, which was great. It just was easy to memorize and fairly quick knit, actually, when I was working on it. In the pattern, there is a cable. I did it without the cable needle, and that saved me a lot of time. So, and now the sun is coming out. So it's snowing like fluffy flakes, and the sun is coming out. So nondescript, more like crazy. Crazy, crazy weather day. Anyway, these socks have the shortest little cuff, and so for Christmas Eve, cast on, I literally on Christmas Eve just did the first little bit of the cuff and that was it. And then I put them down for a little bit and then picked them up in January to finish off. And it has this lovely little cabled pattern down the leg and then a really interesting heel. I'm going to pull these off the blocker. The heel's a little different than most of the other socks I've knit, and it is just a 2x2 heel flap, and then a rounded heel, and then of course a lovely gusset, because gussets are always wonderful, and then patterning on the top of the foot all the way down to a wedge toe. So these are my curling mist socks, and I hope you can see the sparkle in them. They're just so, so fun. Thursday, usually I am, you know, as soon as I wake up, I pop onto Ravelry and any test knit, I put it on Ravelry straight away, and then throughout the day I kind of think, what do I want to put as my caption on Instagram for the socks? Thursday I woke up and pretty much hit the ground running and didn't get to post these until I think about 5 o'clock that night, maybe even 5:30. It was a lot later than I normally would post, and just, I guess, this work from home, as soon as I start work I completely forget about Instagram and Ravelry and all these other things. I did think about it a few times through the day that, oh, I need to do that, but I just didn't quite get to it until later in the day. But look at those beautiful, beautiful socks. So this morning I saw a picture of the next pair of socks. I'm waiting to get the pattern details from that, and I'm trying to figure out my yarns. And there's a little pattern detail I want to see before I do make that choice. And then I did see the pattern 5 socks today, and I do have the pattern 4 number 5, and that's good because May and June are usually really super busy for me, as is February, so I'll be glad to have as many patterns as possible so I can get started and get those done by the deadlines. And hopefully on those days that they're released, I wake up a little bit earlier and put them on Ravelry or onto Instagram. And yeah, it's kind of fun to sort of start thinking about what yarns I'm going to be using for the series. I had originally thought I might go with red and pink yarns throughout, but of course I don't see all the patterns at the get-go. So another thought I had was to do sort of like a rainbow sock along. The Rainbow Chronicles is a nice little thought to maybe stick with. So I've thought about doing a Roy G. Biv, but I'm not sure. So I do have another idea of a color that I'd like to use maybe for the second one. But again, I want to see the pattern details because there's a little feature in the next pattern that I'm not sure what it is. So yes, I am piquing curiosity, but I'm also curious. So I'm excited to start those. And then I get to choose out a project bag and all of that fun stuff. So 3 projects finished this week means that I get to start some new projects. And I'm really, really excited to start the next Sock Society pattern. So these ones, Curling Mist Socks, Sock Society Season 4. Pattern 1, and a finished object, which is fabulous. Those have been done for a couple of weeks now. The next project I am going to share with you was living in my lovely Bird Leg Bags treehouse bag with, gotta share it one more time, this lovely little bauble, glass bauble. And then last week I pointed out that there was a yellow stripe in there, which was really neat. There's also a really cool red stripe in there too, and I think there's some blue. Just such a neat bauble. Anyway, this has the last bit of yarn from my Twinkle Twinkle baby blanket, and I talked about the fact I wanted to use as much yarn as I could. This is how much yarn I have left. So, holding it. This much yarn. That is all I have left. I can't even pull my arms fully straight. So I would say I played a really good game of using up all of the Dragon's Flight. So there it is in 2 strands, doubled. So I won. I was glad I didn't do that extra round that as I was considering. So I did make a few changes, and there are some loose ends on this that also need to be secured. I took this off the blocking mats today, and I'm showing you the wrong side. I still have to secure this first one just into the starting point. And then on the back, I held double when I was changing yarns as I went across. So I just need to snip these, but I wanted to block it first. So then that way it would stretch out as much as possible. So the Twinkle Twinkle Baby Blanket, as I shared with you, this was my Dragon's Flight yarn from Tracy of North Georgia Yarns in DK. And I now have a beautiful, beautiful Twinkle Twinkle Baby Blanket that I am trying my best to, it's so big, it's a little hard to share. So this one, it's not a grocery bag anymore, started in the center and went all the way around. I'm actually going to turn off one of these lights because it's making funny shadows. No, the funny shadows aren't really coming from the light, it's coming from outside. It's that time of year, and I think back in November, same thing, that I get this weird shadow behind me because I just use the lights in the house. I don't have a special setup. I have a beautiful bright window in front of me, couple lights overhead, so lots of shadows on my face, but that's how it is. Anyway, this project started in the center right here, and then you did increases at four spots so that it would turn out square, and it has this gorgeous little star texture throughout, and then it has this gorgeous lacy lattice section here. Here's a corner. And because I wanted to use as much yarn as possible, I decided to do a bit of like a garter or purling on the outside edge. I did think maybe what I should have done was done it as stockinette. This is the back of the blanket, so done it maybe as a stockinette and then had it curl, and then it would have nicely matched this side. But I did like the purling all the way around, so it was just a few rounds of purl and made it just a little bit bigger, so then it gives it probably another inch, which is nice if you're wanting to cuddle under a blanket. So it's not huge, but it is a nice size. So today I will sew in the middle end and clip off the other loose ends, and it will then be pretty much good to go. And I will be sending this to my sister because this is a gift for my sister. I do need to take photographs though, so I might go out and plop this in the snow and take some photographs with the snow as a background. When I took photographs of my curling mist socks, it had just snowed, and I put them down and the white background was just perfect snow. And then when I pulled the socks up, you could see the imprint of the pattern. It was kind of neat. Anyway, this is my lovely Twinkle Twinkle Baby Blanket. It took me, I started it in early April last year and I finished it earlier this week. So, and it's been on the blocking wires for a few days. So just needs to relax. I had the blocking pegs out. The edges just need to relax because they're a little bit wonky right now. But I think this is going to be a very, very loved blanket. And look at that beautiful. The sun is cooperating with me right now. Look at that beautiful, beautiful patterning. And now the sun has come out again. I told you, it was one of those weird February days. Okay, that is all that I have to share on my favorite things. So my plans are to start working on my boxy and to hopefully start pattern two. I think I'll be getting that this evening of the second Sock Society season four pattern. So that will be hopefully what I'm focusing on this week. And it would be really nice in the next week to get my boxy done. It'd probably take me 2 weeks, but you know, I'll get there eventually. And of course, my sky map still needs to be blocked, and then I can start the embroidery on that. But my whips are working down, and that feels good. Just a couple loose ends to do today as well. And I think it was a pretty great knitting week. It's now time for brown paper packages, and I do have a few things to share with you today. As I mentioned earlier, I have been drinking lots of my eucalyptus zest tea. I can't help it. It smells so, so good. I happened to pop onto the Tea Palace site a couple of weeks ago, and it sat in my mind for a little bit. They had eucalyptus zest tea on sale for an absolutely amazing price. It was half price for a kilogram. So I bought a kilogram or two, let's go with the two, of the eucalyptus zest. So now I'm not afraid that I will run out. Before that, it had been sort of my precious tea, and I have a small container left, and then I have two of these big bags of eucalyptus zest, which, oh, I love it. So I was happy it was on sale, and with my caffeine-free kick happening right now, the sale was perfectly timed. So I did buy that, and I could have bought a third one so that I got free shipping, but I decided to try a couple of other things as well. So I did get some organic chamomile calm. Haven't opened this yet. I've got to figure out where I'm going to put it. I've got to get a little packet to put it in. So chamomile is always good when you're having a difficult time sleeping. And I also got some organic lavender loose leaf. And these are just little floral buds or little pieces of lavender like you'd find in a sachet, but it's tea. So I wanted to try that. I really love the Tea Palace's lavender Earl Grey tea that they do. So I bought some lavender, and hopefully that will keep me on my caffeine-free kick with a little bit of variety. Although, you know, the eucalyptus zest, I love it so, so much. I really do, that I don't think I'll ever get sick of it. I do like it with lemon and either a little bit of honey or sugar, but it is just so, so, so amazing. And just thinking about it is making me thirsty right now, so. Sneaky sip in there. And then of course, brown paper packages. I got this gorgeous, gorgeous mug, which I talked about at the beginning of the podcast. And, oh, I do love hand-thrown mugs. They're really, really lovely. The next thing I'm going to share with you, I bought a while ago, and I actually forgot that I had purchased these. We had bought something on Amazon, and I always feel bad when I buy something from Amazon. But these were an add-on, and I've not been able to find these anywhere else for the longest, longest time. And these are my favorite needles to do cross-stitching with, or they're not so pointy. If I'm doing like fixing a button or something like that, I love these needles. And these are the Anchor Gold plated needles. I used to buy them from a store in Canada called Lewis Craft, but Lewis Craft unfortunately closed many, 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 many moons ago. And it used to be pretty much the number one craft store, I believe, in Canada. That was before Michaels came along. And, you could always get some wool and some things at the local department stores. But Lewis Craft was only crafts. And it was just such a lovely store. And I do miss Lewis Craft. I have some beautiful cross-stitch patterns that I bought from them. And then, of course, when I was growing up, that's where we would always buy yarn to make whatever it was, usually acrylic, but sort of nice happy memories. But I always love these Anchor gold plated needles. So I did get the two sizes, and they arrived this week, and I thought it was just something Greg had purchased, so I popped it on the table, and my husband said, no, it's for you. So, oh, and then I remembered, oh yeah, I bought the Anchor needles. They must finally be here. So it took them about a month to get here, but they are here. And as I said, I don't know what it is. They feel right in my hands. And I've never been able to find another needle that I like quite as much. So when I saw that I could get these as an add-on, that is what I did. So, and that is all I have for brown paper packages this week, which I would say was a pretty good week. A mug, some tea, and my favorite needles. That's a nice little treat to have at the beginning of February. If you're going to have a treat, right? Better than chocolate. Not better than chocolate, but healthier than chocolate. It's now time for Bits and Bobs, and this is my segment where I talk about anything and everything not necessarily knitting related. And today I thought I would share with you my best friend from work. And that, oh my goodness, my best friend's not too happy actually. This is my best friend from work, and I haven't been taking very good care of her. This is my Cyclama, and I brought her home at the end of December, and she hadn't bloomed yet, and she has slowly been getting her blooms ready, and they are looking beautiful. I think, though, the window that I have her in at work is a gorgeous, huge, south-facing window, and every year she is just glorious, and I water her to death. And I think the problem right now, and why she's getting some yellow leaves, is I kind of forget to water her when we're at home. So I think she needs a really good water today, because those leaves are turning yellow, and normally they're this beautiful, beautiful dark green. So this is the plant that I bought a few years ago, and every year in the wintertime, she gets these beautiful, beautiful pink flowers. But she started dying off in June one year, and I wasn't sure, you know, I didn't know very much about cyclamas or plants. And so I kept her in her pot, and I threw her into a drawer because I read something about hibernation. And I came back in the fall and started watering and watering her. And she came back and was beautiful. And everybody thought I was crazy because, you know, here I am watering this pot of dirt. And every fall, every September, I pull her out of the drawer, put her in the window, start pouring water in, and she has come back now. I believe this is her fourth year, definitely third, maybe fourth year that she has come back. And yeah, I think this is her fourth year, because the first year she was perfectly new from the store, and then the second year she started to bud in November. Last year she waited until late December, I think, and then this year she started in January. So she tends to bloom a little bit later, but it was just really nice to be able to bring her home with me. And yeah, I need to give her a little bit more water. Poor thing. She doesn't have a name. She's just my beautiful cyclama, and she looks beautiful in my office window. And yeah, everybody thinks I'm crazy because every year I water this pile of dirt and I say, just you watch, just you watch. And it's just so exciting to finally see the leaves coming back. And she has such beautiful green leaves normally when I overwater her at work. But yeah, I think I need to give her a nice good drowning this afternoon. That will be good for her. So that is one thing I wanted to share on Bits and Bobs. And we are still working from home, and we will be at least for the next week. I believe we're supposed to go back on the 16th, and then my lovely cyclama will come back with me and have her lovely spot in the sunshine. She'll be happy there. And I remember to water her a little bit more. Even though I've got her at the back of the house, north facing, she's leaning towards the light, but it's not as much of a beautiful light like she's used to. And I see her, I admire her every day, but I forget to water her. I am also growing some catnip for Tasha, who's lying by the fireplace right now. I have a Click and Grow. Isaac won it last year at Residence, and he was growing some basil at the very beginning. When he first got it, he brought it home last year, and he's left it with me. So I had grown some tomatoes and some strawberries. The strawberries were fantastic, especially once I put them outside and we were always picking at them. And the tomatoes, I transplanted them outside, but unfortunately the squirrels kept getting to them before I ever got a tomato. I took pictures in the summertime of these three gorgeous ripe tomatoes. I thought, I'm going to give them one more day. I went out, all three, oh, two of them were gone. I only got one. And from then on out, the squirrels ate all the tomatoes. So I planted tomatoes, I didn't get any tomatoes, but my morning glories looked wonderful. So catnip is in there now. Previously I had had some lettuce, so we had a couple of salads with the lettuce, and I do have some flowers that I'm wanting to plant as well. So it's kind of a nice little light garden that we set up during the winter time, and in the summer it's nice to sort of start some of those plants. So I'm not much of a gardener. My thumbs are definitely not very green, as you can tell by my yellow-leafed plant. They seem to do a lot better at work, but here, I don't know, I guess there's just so much else to distract me. So, going back to work on the 16th, let's get back onto that train of thought, and it'll be interesting because it's been very, very busy the past month working from home. Tons of emails, a lot more work. I've been working from 8:30 in the morning till many nights 7:30 at night, and breakfast has been happening at dinner time. It's not been very good, but I'm not sure if it's going to be busier or not when we go back, but we'll see. Nathaniel is still working away on homeschooling. We've been working on math this week. He does his math through Prodigy, and he's actually made some really great gains this past week, although there were a couple of days when he was stomping his feet and being a bit of a tyrant and refusing to do his math. But last night, he has gotten now up to 75% done of the curriculum, of the level that he's working on. And I think he sort of was secretly proud of that, though he'd never, ever tell you that. Try to think if there's anything else for bits and bobs. Looking around, it's February, I'm hibernating, I'm enjoying lots of knitting time in the evenings once I finally do kick off work at 7:30, so I have been getting some stuff done as three finished objects this week lets you know, and I've already talked about the fact that I want to pull out the boxy next and work on that, and then I'll be working on the next Sock Society pattern as well. So I think, though, for this week, that's all I've got to share on Bits and Bobs. My lovely Cyclama. She needs a name. Maybe Mary. Mary, my Cyclama. No, I don't know. Cordelia. Cordelia the Cyclama? Maybe. I don't know. Maybe you can send me some suggestions. Anyway, that's all I've got for Bits and Bobs this week. Thank you so much for joining me on the Comfy Red Couch this week. I hope that you've had a chance to sit down and relax and work on that project of choice, and that you have enjoyed a nice refreshing beverage, whatever that may be. And I am wishing you a calm and quiet week ahead. I hope that you get lots done on your projects, and I hope to see you next week on the Comfy Red Couch. Bye. I think maybe she does need a name. I tend to go maybe like a C. Because of Cyclama, or maybe Sally, maybe like a S sounds. Sally the Cyclama? Does Sally match here? Sandra? Celine? Celine the Cyclama? This one is a bit of a diva, and she's got beautiful green leaves. I don't know. have to think about it, but yeah, I probably should name this lovely little girl.